So class 7, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 16, water, a natural resource. So water is a natural resource. So first of all, we should know what is natural resource. So we all are now living in 21st century, where we are developing at a very fast pace, the new technologies, new inventions that makes our lives more comfortable. So we are developing at a very fast pace, but the source of all these new things that are being made up of nature. So the only source of materials for the humans is the earth and its atmosphere, and the materials that we get from nature, that is called natural resource. So water is also a natural resource, because water we are getting from the nature. So the materials that we obtain from the nature, these are called natural resource. So materials that we get from the nature, these are called natural resources. Not only water, there are so many things which we are considering as natural resources, like we need oxygen for breathing, that is we are getting from the nature, medicines from the plants, food from plants and animals, metals from the ores, energy from the sunlight, minerals from the earth's crust, water for drinking and other purposes, fossil fuels for energy, all these are the natural resources. All these we are getting from the nature. So the list is very endless, because there are so many things that nature is providing us. So these natural resources are again classified into two categories, that is renewable and non-renewable resources. So the natural resources or the materials that we got from the nature, these include so many things. Again, these natural resources are classified broadly into two categories, that is renewable and non-renewable resources. So renewable resources, these resources never get completely used up, they get replenished within short span of time. But non-renewable resources, they run out after continuous use and do not get replenished in a long time. So now we will discuss about the renewable and non-renewable resource with few examples. So renewable resources are the resources which never get completely used up, they get replenished within a short span of time. And the examples we can give, like oxygen, it never get completely used up, means when we are using the oxygen, again the plants are producing the oxygen. Similarly, sunlight, water, these are renewable resources. So examples we can take is oxygen. Oxygen is used for the breathing, but it gets completely replenished when plants produce it while doing the photosynthesis. Similarly, sunlight, sun is giving a constant source of energy to us, that is in the form of sunlight. So as long as the sun is there, this resource will never finish. And since the sun is expected to stay around for the next 5 billion years, so we can call it a renewable resource, because as much as the sun is there, we can get the sunlight. So it is a never ending source of energy. Next is our water. So we need water for surviving. So water is used for most of the human activities, for domestic purpose, everyday, day to day life we need water. So however, it comes back to us through rains. So it is also a renewable resource. If at all we are using the water, again it is coming back to the earth in the form of the rain. So evaporation takes place, then condensation and precipitation takes place, and the water is coming to the earth in the form of rain. So we can consider water also a renewable resource. So next is our non-renewable resources. So these are the resources which run out after continuous use and do not get replenished in a long time. So these resources, they run out after continuous use and they do not get replenished in a long time. So if we will take the example of non-renewable resources, then we can consider forest, fossil fuels, then minerals, soil. All these are the examples of non-renewable resources. So we can consider forest as a non-renewable resource, because we cut forest for various purpose, and though even if we plant the trees, it is not possible to create forest in a short time. So forests are considered as non-renewable resource. Similarly, fossil fuels, they took millions of years to form and we are using them continuously. Since we are using them continuously, they will soon get used up completely and we are not likely to get them again till millions of years, because it takes millions of years to form. So it is also considered as non-renewable resource. And for minerals, when we constantly dig the earth to get the minerals, so we are constantly digging. So when we are constantly digging, we are getting minerals, metals, sand, stones and clay for different purposes we are using, and these do not get replenished. So it is also a non-renewable resource. Next is our soil. Soil also can be considered as non-renewable resource because it also takes a very long time to form. So due to deforestation, the soil erosion takes place, and because of the soil erosion, we lose a great amount of the soil, or the great amount of this resource is being lost due to deforestation, because due to deforestation the soil erosion takes place. So this is also considered as non-renewable resource. It takes a very long time to form. So these are considered as non-renewable resource. They run out after continuous use and they do not get replenished in a long time. So a natural resource, they are classified into two broad categories, that is renewable and non-renewable resource. Renewable resource, they never get completely used up and they get replenished within a short span of time. But the non-renewable resource, they run out after continuous use and they do not get replenished in a long time. So nowadays the population is increasing constantly. Population is increasing, so because of the increasing population, the use of resource is also increasing and the demand on nature is dangerously high. So in the future, we on the earth are going to get very difficult time, because some of the resources, we are going to have scarcity of some of the resources. Like one example we can take is water. So there will be scarcity of water, so then we can face a very difficult time on the earth. Though there is abundance of water on the earth, very little amount is available to us. Out of this little, we use a lot and waste more than we use. So due to the ignorance and casual outlook, we are not realizing that the water crisis will cripple the world in near future. So this is all about the natural resource and its classification like renewable and non-renewable resource. In the next class, we will discuss about the water, a renewable resource, and how the water is important and how we are wasting the water. Till then, you read the lesson. Next class, we will discuss about more about water.